Today I'd like to tell you the story of Cutie and the Beast.
Hey, now, once upon a Bobby time baby. In a fuck.
Oh, hiya, Grover. How are you?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, that's okay, Grover.
How you doing, Bobby?
I'm doing
Big
fine.
Bobby?
How are you doing?
Oh, good. What you doing there?
Well, I was about to read a story, Grover.
You're going to read a story?
Mm-hmm.
Can Cutie... I be in the story?
You'd like to be in the story?
Oh, yeah, please.
Well, I don't... Well, we do need a beast.
A beast? Oh, I can pretend I'm a beast.
Could you play the part of a beast?
Oh, yeah, I ain't good actor.
Are you sure?
I go over and get ready.
Okay, you go get ready.
You go ahead and read me, Bob.
Okay, Grover.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye, Grover. Anyway, once upon a time in a far-off kingdom, there lived an old king and his delightful daughter. Now, the king was called Ferdinand the 37th, and his daughter was known as Cutie.
Oh, why, that is my name. My name is Cutie.
Yes, I named her Cutie because she's as cute as a bug's ear.
She is kind of cute, isn't she?
Huh? Oh, yes, I am.
Well, anyway, Cutie and her father lived in regal splendor in the castle. And as the years passed, well, it became time for Cutie to be married.
Father?
Yeah?
Is it not time for me to be getting, you know, married?
Yes, it certainly is. Huh.
But there was only one little problem. You see, there were no eligible princes anywhere in the kingdom. And the king insisted that Cutie must marry a genuine prince.
My daughter, the Princess Cutie, will never marry anyone unless he is a first-class, honest-to-goodness, dyed-in-the-wool, guaranteed prince.
Now, at that moment, a terrible beast appeared and asked Cutie to marry him.
Ta-da! I am a terrible beast, and I would like you to marry me, Cutie.
Oh, she'd love to.
Father, how can you say that?
How can you say that, Father? I mean, King, just a moment ago, you told everybody that your daughter had to marry a genuine A-number-one prince, right?
Oh, yes,
Father. So?
But I know how these stories always work out.
You do?
You see, that terrible beast is a prince that some witch has put a terrible spell on.
No kidding.
Sure, as soon as my daughter, the Princess Cutie, kisses that beast, he'll turn back into a prince.
Wow, I don't believe it.
Oh, sure.
Hello, Cutie.
Terrible beast?
Yes.
I think it's wonderful that you're going to marry my daughter.
Oh, I too think it is wonderful, oh noble king.
Of course, there is one small detail.
What is that?
First, you have to submit to the ordeal of what happens next.
The ordeal of what happens next?
That's right.
You did not tell me about this, Bobby.
I am going to show you three pictures.
Three pictures?
And you have to tell me in each one.
Yeah?
What happens next?
And if I do tell you? Oh, if I do tell you?
You can marry my daughter, the Princess Cutie.
Oh, boy. And if I do not tell you?
Then I throw you in a dungeon full of hoppy toads and itchy bugs.
That seems fair.
Will the terrible beast be able to pass the ordeal of what happens next and marry the princes? Or will he fail and be thrown into the dungeon full of hoppy toads and itchy bugs?
I don't know, Bob.
I don't know either, but you know, I do know something.
What's that?
I'm going to stay tuned for the second part of Cutie and the Beast and find out.
Okay, can I stay here and wait for
you? Sure, I take care of you.
I'm scared.
Okay. Hey, Grover, it's time for part two.
Oh, no, I'm not going. I'm scared.
You better get back.
Oh, but
we got to finish the story.
Yeah, but the ordeal comes next.
I know, but you can do it. Good luck.
Okay, bye, Bob.
Bye-bye. Now, as you remember, the terrible beast wants to marry the Princess Cutie. But first, he must pass the ordeal of what happens next.
It's all right. Just walk this way.
Oh, come here, Cutie. Help me.
Good luck, beast.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's have the first picture.
Oh, there it is already. Oh, boy.
Now you must tell what happens next.
What happens next in the picture, huh?
Yes.
Okay, let me see. There's a little kitty, and the kitty is on the table, and there's a doggy there, and the doggy has scared the kitty, and the kitty has knocked over the vase, and what happens next is that the vase falls on the doggy. Huh?
The vase falls on the doggy.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yay!
Oh, oh, oh. Wait. Oh, oh. Am I through?
No.
Oh. Oh.
The second picture, please.
The second picture. Oh, that looks hard. Let me see. What happens next in that picture? Well, there's a little boy, and the little boy is holding a fishing pole, and he is sitting down there, and there's some water underneath, and the fish is in the water, and there is a worm on the hook there, and the fish is about to bite the worm, and the little boy is going to catch the fish.
Correct.
Oh yeah. Right. Oh.
Wait.
Am I through?
No.
Oh.
The last picture, please.
Oh. What is it? Oh, that looks like a toughie. Let me see what happens next in that picture. There is a street, and there is a car there, and there is a stoplight there, and there is a red stoplight, and the car is coming down the street. The car is going to stop. Is that what happens next?
That is right.
Oh, cutie.
You get to marry my daughter, Cutie.
Oh, boy. Oh, Cutie.
Hey, he did a pretty good job at that, huh? Well, now, let's see.
Now, what really happens next is my daughter, the Princess Cutie, will kiss the terrible beast, and he will turn into a prince.
That's what really happens next, huh, King?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, so Cutie kissed the beast. What happened next was that Cutie turned into a beautiful lady beast.
Lady beast?
What?
Oh, Cutie! Wow!
I used to be a beautiful lady beast, but a long time ago a witch cast a spell on me and turned me into a cute little princess.
These fairy tales never turn out the way you expect them.
Cutie, you beautiful! Oh.
And so what happens next is that, everybody lives happily ever after. I guess.